Kellogg, and I'm Pablo Gunner, here to talk to you about nerdy fitness stuff, which is like nerdy things and fitness things. So that includes my workouts, food, music, shows, movies, comics, video games, whatever I was into this month at all, or last month really. So this was a weird month because it was my birthday was towards the end, so I didn't work out that week. I took vacation that week, most of the week, so I didn't work out. I ran once. I did for that week. So here's the workouts I did. For week one, I did Asgardian Arms. That was day one. Then day two, I did a 2.25 mile run in 20 minutes and 15, and then Avengers Abs. You can look that up. I'll post the extended version so you see the abs workout that I did for that on the website. So then day three, I did yoga, X training, back and legs. Day four, abs. Day five, 3 mile run in 27 minutes. Which was probably on the treadmill if I had to guess, because that's probably the only way I could achieve that speed. And any of the days that I did yoga, most likely I was with my dad. We were both doing yoga, so that was cool. And then week two, day one, I did 3.25 mile run in 20 minutes, abs and buys. And then for day two, yoga for that week. Day three, 2 mile run in 17 minutes, legs. And then I did push-ups, sit-ups, and my legs workouts. That was that. It was really weird too, because here's another thing that happened is, I was told, I might have mentioned this in the last video, there's this thing going on, essentially these tryouts. And so I was like, okay, I'll go for it. I mean, at first I was like, I really don't have time. I don't have time, so I'm not doing it. But these guys were bugging me. So I was like, all right, fine. They're like, oh, they extended it an extra week. I was like, okay, fine, I'll put in for it. I print the paperwork, did the paperwork, put in for it the day of, like the final day. And it wasn't accepted, it wasn't whatever, so I was changed my workouts to fit these tryouts, right? And so, because it's like you gotta do a mile in under 8.5 minutes, which is easy, yes. You gotta do push-ups, and, you know, do as many push-ups as you can, do as many sit-ups as you can, sit and reach. Then there's this obstacle course, and you gotta do that in 9.5 minutes. But there's things to it though. Like it's the whole thing is points based. So if you don't make enough points, then you're not gonna pass. Even if you pass everything at the end, if you don't have enough points, you're not going to pass it. So I changed my workouts to that. So I was like, okay, I hadn't been running, so I was like, I didn't feel prepared honestly, and I was like, but screw it, I'm gonna put in for it anyways. And so I was like, my run needs a lot of help, because I went from like below 6:30 to probably around, well, I checked the other day, it was like 7:30, around 7:30. So not like I lost a minute time there. And so anyways, like I said, for my birthday week, the week three, day one, 2 mile track run, that's what I did. I think that was all together, and I think that was probably the day that I tested myself for the 7. I got like 7:28. Week 4, because I took so much time off for my birthday, amongst other things that have been going on, I'm going to work my second day off, and then I decided to work my first day off on the next week. So I essentially would work 7 days straight. So because of that, I was also able to work out 6 days straight, essentially. So for day one, 4.82 mile run in 51 minutes and 28 seconds. And then for day two, I did abs and chest. Like I said, once again, I was gearing towards this. I wanted to get my sit-ups and my push-ups. So that's what I did. I just did a lot of sit-ups and a lot of push-ups. I did it with weights. And then day three, I did a 2.3 mile treadmill run in 20 minutes. Then I did pull-downs and sled pulls. Like I said, that's something that's part of like the obstacle course. You gotta jump a wall and you gotta pull a sled. So I was doing those and I was like, oh, I'll step it up each time I do it, you know, for the weight. Because I had started with only under 20 pounds with the weight pulls, but I was like, I'll add, you know, 10, 20 pounds each time. Day four, abs and chest. Like I said, once again, back at it, you know, wanted to make sure I was good on those push-ups and those sit-ups. Day five, I did a 3.9 mile track run in 41 minutes and 27 seconds. And then day six, 3.0 mile run in 44 minutes. And then day seven, I did buys, tries, and abs. That was, I think that's when I was like, I found out that I was not going to be doing the tryouts, because for whatever reason, I don't care. And that's the other thing, I don't care. I was not bummed out. I was like, all right, oh well. I mean, I really only did it because those guys were, you know, wanted me to do it, you know, and not because I felt prepared, you know, like I would have been totally down for it if I would have felt prepared, but I didn't. I feel like my runtime is getting better, but it's still not where I want it to be. Like I said, I don't want to just show up and barely skate by. I want to be the number one dude, and that's it. So if I'm not, then I'm not. Then I don't really want to do it. So I think, you know, everything kind of works out the way it's supposed to. I also kind of feel like it would have been like my fourth try or something like that. So I kind of feel like it's not my destiny. You know, it's not my journey to do that. Or maybe it is and it's later down the road. I don't know. We'll see. So I did a hardcore buys and tries and abs workout, which was pretty solid. For food, I had been eating really clean and really healthy. So cod, broccoli, brown rice, Chobani yogurt, which isn't organic, but it's still Greek yogurt and pretty good for you. It has a lot more sugar. And then organic cheese stick, mango chips, which I kind of, they were making me sick with certain other food. Like if I would eat it with other food, it would just, I don't know what it was. It was weird. I don't know. Something in it was making my stomach upset. So snack pack, and not the snack pack from Billy Madison, you know, of like the pudding, but the snack pack that I have, which is like it's half cashews or like almonds and like dried fruit, like cranberries or cherries or something like that. And then the other side's a cheese. Vegetable straws, I bought a big old bag of vegetable straws. I had been sharing that with my dad. Chicken and rice. Burrito, or is it just burrito? Salmon, broccoli, and brown rice. I bring in salads, fruit, Noosa yogurt. As of late, I've been eating a lot of Rudy's brisket and corn. And then a rice, chicken, vegetable bag, which I'm all out of that. So I do have to stock up on groceries pretty hardcore coming up once I get paid this week. On my days off, like I said, I eat whatever I want. But I also realized this, that now that I've been running with my work buddy again, that I am starving through at least half of the shift when I run, when I do long distance running, like when I do, you know, the 3.9 or whatever, where I'm going like almost 4 to 5 miles, I am starving about halfway through the shift. And I usually take enough food for a double shift in case, because I've been so hungry, I've been going through my food like crazy, and then I'm like, I don't have enough food for a double. And I'm like, ah. So, because there was one night I wanted to work a double and I couldn't because I had eaten all my food. I guess I could have just bought food the next day, but I don't like to waste time, and I'm a cheapo, so I don't like to waste money either, even though that's not a waste because it's food. So I've also realized I can pretty much eat whatever I want because I'm running so much. Like, it's crazy, I'm eating whatever I want and I still look chiseled. Like, still got that nice V-line and everything, and I'm like, wow, like this is ridiculous. I do need to work on abs more. I do need to do lift more, because now that I'm just running, now that I've mostly been doing running, I've been losing muscle mass. I can tell, like, yeah, I look lean and I look cut, but I need to also lift. So instead of doing it every other day. I mean, that's what I'm going to do, is every other day I'll run long distance every other day, and then in between those days do the heavy lifting, because I just don't think I have the energy to run, to work out, to lift at night after I've done that run. I mean, I might be able to, but I feel like I'm just going to tire myself out if I do that. For music, I just started getting into Dierks Bentley. I listened to his new album. I listened to all of his, like, a mix of his hits, and I was like, all right, I don't know why he has his own tour, because I don't think he's that great. But I listened to The Mountain, and it's a solid album. It's not, like, my favorite country album. I've also been listening to all the bands. We went to, me and Slay J, we went and saw Hawthorne Heights, and like I said, last month I've been listening to them nonstop, and then this one, we saw the bands, the other bands that played, so I checked them out. Listener, Hotel Books, Sienna Skies, Heavy Things, those are the bands that I've been listening to. Their most recent albums mostly is what I listen to. Don't really care for Hotel Books. Listener is alright. They're really great live. They really capture the energy and stuff with the instrumentals. Sienna Skies is really solid. They're pretty good. I like them. Heavy Things, you can tell they're brand new. They're gonna get better with time. They're gonna get more confident. But they're pretty solid. And then shows and movies, I really haven't been doing that much. But I have been watching Krypton a little bit. It's slowly but surely getting better. They're going into the Brainiac stuff, so, which is pretty cool and looks pretty awesome. I've been watching Riverdale with the wife. You know, it's already like guilty pleasure. It's mindless, enjoyment. And then I've been slowly getting caught up on Arrow as well. It's all right. It's not too bad. And then Slay J came over and we watched Step Brothers and Billy Madison. And those movies are, I mean, Step Brothers is definitely funnier, but like, for Billy Madison, like, it's still funny. And then gaming, I started playing Marvel's Strike Force, the mobile game. It's decent. That's another one. It's just like mindless. Kirby Star Allies with the wife, I've been playing that. There was also E3, and that was freaking awesome and amazing. I think Microsoft killed it because they had the most games to put out, and they were big. They were big games. Whereas, like, PlayStation focused on just a few games and made big presentations of those few games. So it was different. Oh, I also played Breath of the Wild. And then for comics, Batman's been awesome lately. It's been freaking crazy and awesome. Hal Jordan, the Green Lantern Corps, it's just always looks great, but it's really interesting, really awesome. Venom, there's a new Venom, and it's Eddie Brock again, but it's a different writer. And so that's really awesome. Power Rangers books have been really great. And Punisher in the War Machine armor has been sick. So yeah, check all that stuff out. I wasn't able to go to the convention last month for Phoenix Comic Fest, but we are supposed to go to Duke City Comic Con. So I will be doing my Namor and Aquaman for that. And then after that, I'll probably find a new goal. But I think the thing that works best right now is lift one day, or run one day on my Monday, run on my Friday. And then in between those days is lift. So, and I can eat whatever I want. It's great. It's beautiful. So, yeah. And I haven't been able to work out with my dad that much just because our schedules have been different. And so he's been coming in early for work, or I've been coming in early for work. And that's continuing. I do want to ask, what is your favorite basketball team? Because the finals had just passed. And it was disappointing, the way it all went down. I want to know what your basketball team is. Obviously, mine is the Bulls because I grew up with Jordan and everything. So, and, you know, we can argue about that another time. But that's it for me. I want to know what your favorite basketball team is. So, stay fit, stay healthy, and stay nerdy. Love and peace.